Jerusalem, where Jesus spent the last 24 hours of his life on earth, where he departed to heaven from, and where he will soon return. Join Jonathan again as he travels to Jerusalem to retrace those final hours of Yeshua's life. Today, Jonathan looks at Yeshua's prayer at the Gardens of Gethsemane before his arrest. It was here that Yeshua cried out to his Father and was strengthened. Encouraging words to any of you facing a trial in your life. Today on Jewish Voice.
Shalom and welcome to Jewish Voice, a program to help you to understand the Jewish roots of your Christian faith, Bible prophecy, and world events surrounding Israel. We're focusing in the next few weeks immediately following Passover and Easter on the final 24 hours of Yeshua's life. Those last hours changed the course of human history. It was those final moments where he became our Passover lamb by laying down his life for us. Now, 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 7 and 8 declares that Christ, or Messiah, our Passover lamb, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us keep the festival. It's talking about Passover, not with the old bread leavened with malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. And then 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 18 and 19, I love this so much. For you know that it was not with perishable things, such as silver and gold, that you were redeemed from the empty way of life handed down to you from your ancestors, but with the precious blood of Messiah, a lamb without blemish or defect. The final Passover meal that Yeshua celebrated with his disciples on Mount Zion was the beginning of that final 24 hours, that final day of his life. And during that Seder, which we've already looked at, he announces to his disciples that he is going to lay down his life, that his body will be broken for them and for the world, and that his blood would be shed for the remission of sin. So he declares that in this final Passover Seder with his disciples. And then we're told that after they sang a hymn, this was their traditional hymn, probably Psalm 118, they left the upper room on the Mount of Olives, and they walked down through the Kidron Valley and then up the slope of the Mount of Olives to a place called Gethsemane. And Jesus said to his disciples, they went to a place called Gethsemane, and Jesus said to his disciples, sit here while I pray. We're told that he took Peter, James, and John, the inner circle of the 12, the three, along with him, and he began to be deeply distressed and troubled. And this is the declaration, verse 34, my soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death. Stay here and keep watch. Now, Gethsemane is a corruption into English of two Hebrew words, got, which means press, and shemanim, which is oil. So literally, this means olive press, or the place where the oil is pressed. And it's very interesting that on the slope of the Mount of Olives, you see this area, this olive grove with trees that are over 2,000 years old. In other words, it was a place of pressing olives. It's a place of pressing olives today, or an olive grove today. And it was an olive grove 2,000 years ago in the time of Yeshua. So he came here to pray. And I believe that you have two ideas here with the oil or olive oil and the press. First of all, you have the symbolism of the Bible when it talks about oil being the presence of God, the outpouring of the oil, the presence of the Spirit of God. Oil was used for anointing priests and kings, and it was also used to bring light. We have the menorah, and of course, oil is the material that produces the light and was used in the tabernacle in the wilderness. And so first you have Yeshua seeking the presence of his Father. He's seeking guidance and empowerment from the Spirit of God. And then second, he's enduring great stress, this pressing on him, this pressure. Have you ever felt pressure before? Have you ever felt anxiety before? I'm sure all of you have. So did Yeshua. And then going on a little further in verse 35, it says that he, he fell to the ground and he prayed that if possible, the hour might pass from him. Verse 36, Abba, Father, he said, everything is possible for you. If it's possible, take this cup from me. This is amazing. Here is the Son of the living God saying, if it's possible, take this cup from me. Take this burden from me. But then, of course, the great words, nevertheless, it's not what I want. It's not my will, but your will be done. But what you desire. This is so amazing. He even prayed for a way out. Have you ever thought about that before? Have you ever had something that you just didn't want to do but had to do? For some of you, that happens daily, if not hourly. Sure, we do. All of us have things that we don't want to do, and we need to do them. Paul said, the things that I don't want to do, I do, and the things that I'm supposed to do or should be doing, I don't. This is Yeshua's humanity expressed. He wanted to get out of this in his flesh. In his flesh, he says, take this away from me. If there's any way to get out of this, I want out. But it's not what I want. Your will be done. And friends, that's what a walk with the Lord is about. It's about dying to self. It's about saying, I don't want to do this. Or the things that I want to do, I know I shouldn't be. Your will be done. And one last point, because I don't have much time left. He's alone in this. He did this alone. He returns. His disciples are sleeping. He goes back and prays. He goes again, and they're sleeping. They couldn't keep watch with him. He had to do this alone. My friends, sometimes it's you and God, and that's it. We have to do it alone, and it's all about getting strength from him. Yet in the midst of the press, we say, your will be done. Your will be done. So this is the next significant moment that takes place in those final 24 hours of Yeshua's life on earth. His prayer in the garden leading up to his sacrificial death for us in ancient Jerusalem almost 2,000 years ago. When we come back, we'll take you to Jerusalem where all of this took place almost 2,000 years ago. We'll show you a clip from a new video we just finished, just released, and it's available to you now. It's called His Final Footsteps, Retracing the Last 24 Hours of Yeshua's Life. We'll be right back.
Your gracious gift in support of the work of Jewish Voice right now will make you a vital part of providing life-saving medical help to some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. Today, we are currently preparing for one of our next medical clinics to bless a remote Lost Tribes community in Zimbabwe who clearly have ties to the ancient people of Israel, particularly the Levites, and have been practicing distinctly Jewish customs for centuries. Our medical teams will provide more than just physical care and comfort. They will share God's love and the good news that Jesus is their promised Messiah. Today, we urgently need your help to equip and fund this vital upcoming outreach. Time is literally running out for many of the most vulnerable there, especially infants and toddlers. You can help save them, but you must act now. Will you be a blessing to these needy Jewish people? Call or click right now to share life-saving help, and we'll send you the full DVD presentation highlighted on today's broadcast. His Final Footsteps, Retracing the Last 24 Hours of Jesus' Life. as our special thank you for sharing a gift of any size. In this inspiring new DVD presentation, filmed on location in Jerusalem, Jonathan Burness serves as your guide to reliving and understanding the most important 24 hours in human history. The final Passover meal in the upper room, the anguish in the Garden of Gethsemane, the betrayal and arrest on the Mount of Olives, the mockery of his trial, the barren hill of execution. These and other spots mark key milestones as Yeshua, Jesus, moved through his final pivotal hours on earth. This journey through Jerusalem that retraces Yeshua's final footsteps will deepen your understanding of his great love for you and encourage you in your faith. And it is yours for sharing a life-saving gift of any amount today. Plus, if God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $100 or more today, we'll send you the DVD presentation just mentioned, plus two additional gifts to bless you for being a blessing to some needy Jewish people. You'll receive Jonathan Burness's insightful DVD presentation titled, A Rabbi Looks at Israel, Land of the Bible, Land of the Messiah, and our beautiful lion and lamb statue. Let it grace your home or office as a deeply meaningful reminder that Yeshua is both the Lion of the Tribe of Judah and our Passover Lamb. Please remember, God has promised to bless those who bless the Jewish people. To share a gift in support of this vital outreach and request your thank you resources, please call, click, or write now. And remember, your generous gift will make you a part of extending life-saving medical help to some very needy Jewish people. Jerusalem, where Jesus spent the last 24 hours of his life on earth, where he departed to heaven from, and where he will soon return. Join Jonathan again as he travels to Jerusalem to retrace those final hours of Yeshua's life. Today, Jonathan looks at Yeshua's prayer at the Gardens of Gethsemane before his arrest. It was here that Yeshua cried out to his Father and was strengthened. Encouraging words to any of you facing a trial in your life. Today on Jewish Voice.
Not too long ago, I traveled to Israel with a film crew, and we went to Jerusalem and retraced the last 24 hours of Jesus' life. Amazingly, the various things that took place in those last 24 hours were all prophesied in the Jewish scriptures hundreds of years before he ever came to earth. So here's a look at the project that I undertook with my team here at Jewish Voice in Jerusalem as we retrace those final 24 hours of his life. It's called His Final Footsteps, Retracing the Last 24 Hours of Jesus' Life. Take a look.
We're talking about the place where Yeshua, where Jesus celebrated that final Seder with his disciples, the Last Supper, which was actually a Passover meal with his disciples, the traditional Passover Seder meal as he prepared himself to be led as the Passover lamb to the slaughter. Now, first of all, the Passover was a commanded observance in Torah for the children of Israel as part of a cycle of celebration, as part of a cycle of feasts. And in Leviticus chapter 23, we're given this cycle, and it begins with the Passover and unleavened bread. In Leviticus 23, look at verse 4 with me. It says, "These are the Lord's appointed feasts, the sacred assemblies you are to proclaim at their appointed times. The Lord's Passover begins at twilight on the 14th day of the first month." The Passover was the very first instituted celebration of the year that took place in the first of the month in the biblical calendar, Abib or Nisan. So let's go on from there. On the 15th day of the month, verse 6, "The Lord's Feast of Unleavened Bread begins. For 7 days you must eat bread made without yeast. On the first day, hold a sacred assembly and do no regular work. For 7 days, present an offering made to the Lord by fire. And on the seventh day, hold a sacred assembly." Now, I want to draw your attention again to verse 7 specifically, which says, "The first day you are to hold a sacred assembly and do no work." This is the command to observe what we call the Seder meal. And we pick up the story of the Passover in Exodus chapter 12. Let's look there together in Exodus chapter 12, beginning in verse 1. The Lord speaks to Moses and Aaron in Egypt. This month is to be for you the first month of your year. This is the biblical first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel that on the 10th day of this month, each man is to take a lamb for his family, one for each household. If any household is too small for a whole lamb, they must share one with their nearest neighbor, having taken into account the number of people there are. You are to determine the amount of lamb needed in accordance with what each person will eat. The animals you choose must be a year old male without defect, and you may take them from the sheep or the goats. Take care of them until the 14th day of the month, when all the people of the community of Israel must slaughter them at twilight. Then they are to take some of the blood and put it on the sides and tops of the door frames of the houses where they eat the lambs. That same night, they are to eat the meat roasted over fire along with bitter herbs and bread made without yeast. Now let me point out a few things here about this story, because this is an incredible foreshadow of what Yeshua would do for us in his atonement. In fact, you have in this Passover story the entire gospel message. It's just absolutely incredible. Thousands of years before Yeshua was ever born, this laid out the whole picture of the Lamb of God who would take the sins of the world. So let me point out some details that I want you to see here. First of all, we're told that everyone needed a lamb. The Bible says that everyone falls short of the glory of God, that all have sinned, that all of us are separated from God, and so everyone needs the lamb. It's not about a select group of people. Everyone needs the atonement of the Lamb of God. So it was for the whole assembly. We're also told that this lamb was to be in the prime of life. This lamb was to be without defect. This lamb was to be perfect. And Yeshua's the Passover lamb was without defect. He was perfect. In other words, he was without sin. He was born without sin. He lived a sinless life before God here on this earth. This is the Passover lamb in every detail, the lamb without blemish, the Passover lamb. Let's go on to verse 7 now. Then they are to take some of the blood and put it on the sides and tops of the door frames of the houses where they eat the lambs. That same night, they are to eat the meat roasted over the fire along with bitter herbs and bread made without yeast. So this male lamb without defect, without blemish, was to be sacrificed. And the blood was the key. The Bible says that the blood is the life of the flesh, and without blood there is no atonement. So this perfect lamb was slaughtered. The blood was taken and applied to the doorposts of the houses of the children of Israel. This is very critical. This is the gospel message, because it's the blood that's going to cause death to pass over them. And then they're to eat three things. They're to go into this home with the blood-covered doorposts, and they're to eat this meal. The three things that were commanded in Scripture were, first, matzah. This is bread made without yeast. You've maybe seen the square matzah, but this is much closer to the traditional matzah that Yeshua would have eaten with his disciples. Unleavened bread made without yeast to remind us that they left Egypt in haste. They didn't have time to bake the bread for the dough to rise. And so they, as soon as the angel of death passed over and killed the firstborn, including Pharaoh's household, they were told to leave. And so they had to leave in haste. And so this is very similar, I think, to what the matzah looked like in the time of Yeshua. Unleavened bread, the first thing they were commanded to eat.
If you want to better understand how those last 24 hours of Jesus' life changed history forever and what it means for us, for you, then you'll want to get a copy of my latest DVD, His Final Footsteps, Retracing the Last 24 Hours of Jesus' Life. Oh, by the way, up next, an important update on a tribe of Jewish people who desperately need your help. Stay with us.
Yeah. Your gracious gift in support of the work of Jewish Voice right now will make you a vital part of providing life-saving medical help to some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. Today, we are currently preparing for one of our next medical clinics to bless a remote Lost Tribes community in Zimbabwe who clearly have ties to the ancient people of Israel, particularly the Levites, and have been practicing distinctly Jewish customs for centuries. Our medical teams will provide more than just physical care and comfort. They will share God's love and the good news that Jesus is their promised Messiah. Today, we urgently need your help to equip and fund this vital upcoming outreach. Time is literally running out for many of the most vulnerable there, especially infants and toddlers. You can help save them, but you must act now. Will you be a blessing to these needy Jewish people? Call or click right now to share life-saving help, and we'll send you the full DVD presentation highlighted on today's broadcast. His Final Footsteps, Retracing the Last 24 Hours of Jesus' Life, as our special thank you for sharing a gift of any size. In this inspiring new DVD presentation, filmed on location in Jerusalem, Jonathan Burness serves as your guide to reliving and understanding the most important 24 hours in human history. The final Passover meal in the upper room, the anguish in the Garden of Gethsemane, the betrayal and arrest on the Mount of Olives, the mockery of his trial, the barren hill of execution. These and other spots mark key milestones as Yeshua, Jesus, moved through his final pivotal hours on earth. This journey through Jerusalem that retraces Yeshua's final footsteps will deepen your understanding of his great love for you and encourage you in your faith. And it is yours for sharing a life-saving gift of any amount today. Plus, if God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $100 or more today, we'll send you the DVD presentation just mentioned, plus two additional gifts to bless you for being a blessing to some needy Jewish people. You'll receive Jonathan Burness's insightful DVD presentation titled, A Rabbi Looks at Israel, Land of the Bible, Land of the Messiah, and our beautiful lion and lamb statue. Let it grace your home or office as a deeply meaningful reminder that Yeshua is both the Lion of the Tribe of Judah and our Passover Lamb. Please remember, God has promised to bless those who bless the Jewish people. To share a gift in support of this vital outreach and request your thank you resources, please call, click, or write now. And remember, your generous gift will make you a part of extending life-saving medical help to some very needy Jewish people.
I want to show you a tribe in Zimbabwe that has retained Old Testament traditions and rituals for over 2,500 years. They're called the Lemba, and we recently held a wonderful outreach to provide medical care, dental care, eyeglasses, medicines, all completely free of charge. But most importantly, we shared the Messiah with them, and many, many came to faith, thousands in fact, and it was people just like you that helped us to make a difference in their lives. Take a look.
In one of the most remote areas of southern Zimbabwe, a team of 51 volunteers were joined by 120 national workers. And together, they just finished one of the most challenging and rewarding Jewish Voice outreaches to date. In a week full of both work and ministry, the Lord's hand was clearly seen as Jewish Voice conducted its very first medical outreach to the impoverished Lemba Jewish community.
We've seen children who couldn't speak, they couldn't hear, They couldn't do anything. I'm shocked. And then they can speak, and they can hear, and they can say their names. Babies that there was this 18-month-old baby that couldn't even stand up or sit up, nothing. And then it had witchcraft bracelets on its wrist. They were cut off, and the baby sat up immediately. I mean, eyes to see with adults. I've seen so many miracles. My heart is just filling up. I'm forever going to be changed over this entire experience. It's the best thing that has ever happened to me.
The Lord is looking down on this with favor, and he's looking down on this that he loves culture and he loves diversity. And I had such a warm, wonderful feeling that The Lemba here are very gentle and loving people, and that the Lord has not forgotten them, and that they have retained as much as they possibly can of their culture and of their Jewishness.
There's so much more to do. We'd love to have you join us on one of our medical outreaches. For more information or to volunteer, you can call 800-299-9374, or you can go to www.pleaseanswerthecall.org. All one word, pleaseanswerthecall.org.
The Spirit moving mightily, miracles, fulfilled prophecy, marveling as Jesus calls his people back to himself in preparation for his return, serving as his hands and feet in far-flung places around the globe. I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me. The king will reply, I tell you the truth. Whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers of mine, you did for me. This is what outreach is about with Jewish Voice. You can be a part of it. Now is the time. Answer the call. To find out how, call 1-800-299-9374 or go to www.pleaseanswerthecall.org.
Since 1967, Jewish Voice has been dedicated to proclaiming the good news that Yeshua, Jesus, is Messiah and Savior to the Jew first and also to the nations. Now, one way we do this is by helping some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. We've been able to demonstrate God's love by providing these people with medical care, dental care, eye surgeries, all free of charge, but most importantly, we share the gospel, and it's because of your faithful support that we're able to make a difference in their lives. But we need your help. I want to ask you to be part of saving lives, of transforming lives, and blessing desperate Jewish people by sharing a generous gift today. Will you consider doing that? If your answer is yes, we have some very special ways of saying thank you today. I've selected some helpful and encouraging resources that I'd like to send you. You can call or click or write now to share and request them all. And remember, your generous gift is going to be used to help some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. Hey, by the way, we're on Facebook. You can check us out by going to facebook.com/Jewish Voice. Well, that's all the time we have for today. As I leave you, I want to remind you, as I do in every program, to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. The Bible promises they shall prosper that love thee. Until next time, this is Jonathan Bernis saying shalom and God bless you.
Jewish Voice is made possible by the support of friends and partners like you.